how will NLP affect the growing gap in politics and opinion that we have out in the world today? I think that the jury is kind of out on that. It's hard to say whether it's going to take it one way or the other. But we can talk a bit about the way in which it might affect either direction, right? Of either accelerating our kind of political gap or helping us to shrink that. So one of the ways that NLP is going to help potentially accelerate that gap, right, is by creating a lot of content much more quickly by using tools like ChatGPT that create content, right? And the thing, the impact that clearly ChatGPT has, and I think we all see that, is that it makes us much faster at creating content, and it makes it much easier, whether you're a high school student or a journalist or a marketer, right? It's clearly a tool for creating a lot of content. And so it's very easy, as we've seen with initial experimentation with ChatGPT, to lead it to say certain things and whatnot. And of course, with a human in the loop, you can use it to create content that kind of increases bias, uses facts in a maligned way to create maybe malinformation, what the industry calls now, instead of disinformation, misinformation, malinformation, right? To create malinformation to really sway groups of people into a radical direction. So that's one of the ways that I think NLP can accelerate that gap and radicalization. But one of the ways that NLP can help us solve that, right, is by actually analyzing all of this output, whether it's created using the chat tools or created just by human writers, the way we always have, right? But analyzing that that output and what's written to detect and expose the biases that are inherent, or perhaps the malinformation or the blatant misinformation, right? That exists in articles that or media commentary that is pulling us in different directions, right? And by helping to expose that, it may help us cure some of that problem.